January 16, Wednesday of the first week in Ordinary Time. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening, after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak because they knew him. Rising very early before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and in finding him said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go on to the nearby villages, that I may preach there also. For this purpose have I come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord. He cured many who were sick. Jesus' ministry of establishing the kingdom of God continues with the healing of various diseases and casting out demons as foretold by Isaiah. He cures Simon's mother-in-law and many others. Jesus' healing ministry goes hand in hand with his preaching and teaching. The church today continues Jesus' proclamation of God's kingdom in concrete situations of people's lives. Many of the entry points of the church are most palpable in the healing ministry, both physical and spiritual. When the body is healed, the spirit is ready to hear the word of God, or the word of God prepares the person for healing. Pope Francis says, "Jesus introduces us to these works of mercy in his preaching so that we can know whether or not we are living as his disciples. Let us rediscover these corporal works of mercy to feed the hungry, give drink to the thirsty, clothe the naked, welcome the stranger, heal the sick, visit the imprisoned, and bury the dead. And let us not forget the spiritual works of mercy to counsel the doubtful, instruct the ignorant, admonish sinners, comfort the afflicted, forgive offenses, bear patiently those who do us ill, and pray for the living and the dead."